Leo and Danny show.
We're going to call her, I call her Mrs. Robinson.
Hello, you've...
Please edit that completely out.
Just bleep it though, because that's real
that's funny.
Funny. That was. That's, can that, we do that, Osti? Can was, you write that down?
That was perfect comedic timing, dude. You,
that was. It said her full name, like right after. You can hear it.
That was so.
Is
funny.
That? Is she calling
call
back?
From Mrs. Robinson.
Ooh.
To accept, press 1. To send a
voice
call and mail,
collect?
Press 2.
Hello.
Hello.
Hi, this is Leo. You're on the Leo and Danny show. Danny's besides me. How are you, Miss Robinson?
Oh, can we pull up the Simon and Garfunkel song? Can we do that, Austin?
Miss Robinson, can you hear me?
This is such a special occasion.
Yes, I can hear you. Yes,
how are you? How are you, baby?
I'm doing great, sweetie. How are you?
I'm good. Nice
happy
to...
Happy birthday.
Thank you so much. Thank you. She said happy birthday. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we wanted to talk to you today because, you know, we are getting heavily canceled out there and... And it's mainly because there's these obese women are very, very upset about a joke that Danny made. You're caught up to the story, right?
Yeah, I read some of the comments yesterday, and I think it's just a load of shit.
Yes! Mrs. Robinson, play the song!
Yeah.
Damn it, fucking YouTube.
That I appreciate that so much, Miss Robinson. Why do you think it's a load of shit?
Well, there's a lot. I can tell you my own personal story. And I will gladly do that. But let me tell you about the fat chick thing. Let me tell you about it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Every guy has a fat side chick. Okay? Look at each other.
Sorry, baby.
Don't make eye contact. No, okay? Right? Can you
yes.
hear me?
Yes, yes, mm-hmm. yes.
So guys have a fat side chick, but it's like a guy code thing. Everybody has one. You don't talk about it.
It's true.
People, all side chicks. That's just the way it is. Come on. Leo, tell him. I mean,
Danny, you know, I've had my fair share in my day, Miss Robinson.
I do know, honey. And the thing is, so the fat chicks, they'll do anything. Mm-hmm. Anything. Okay? So you wanna have a really good time? There's something you wanna do you've never done, you don't wanna do it with your girlfriend. You wanna know what's up. You know, you might
right.
not ask her to do things. You'd ask somebody else. So
certain things.
What would you do with her specifically, Mrs. Robinson? What should we do with fat girls?
Yeah, what should we do with fat girls?
You could ask them to do anything that you've never had done to you before that you wanna have done to you. Or
absolutely.
You know, like
ass
I mean,
licking.
If you're just really into, here's the deal. If you're really into getting a tongue in your ass and your girlfriend's not into it, have your fat side she'll do it. Right?
Absolutely.
You know, if you want a blowjob 4 times a week without any conversation or reciprocation,
mm-hmm.
have your fat side chick do that. She'll do it. And then you can tell her to leave. Right?
So, I don't want to misquote you, Miss Robinson. What you're saying is the proper way to handle a fat girl is tell her to lick your asshole, tell her to suck your dick 4 times a week, and then leave.
And this is coming from a former, and you, at your heaviest, what would you say you were, Miss Robinson?
Oh, okay. I'm 5 feet tall, so mm-hmm. I'm very short, right? I weighed 255 pounds.
You weighed 255 pounds at one point?
Yes, at
there
one
are
point.
Defensive ends who weigh less.
How, what,
I
know. Why did
you
just...
weighed more than Leo.
Well, you weighed more than me, yes. What did you, right. when did you decide to do the surgery, and was it gastric bypass?
Yeah, it was a gastric bypass. I did it about 10 or 15 years ago. 10 or so. I mean, but the reason I waited so long to do it is it's expensive. Now, insurance and stuff covered it. I paid cash for mine because it wasn't really covered back then.
How much did it cost?
And I was about $15,000.
Affordable!
15,
we were thinking it was going to be 100 grand.
We were thinking it was going to be 100 grand. Oh, wow.
Oh, no. But I did go to a plastic surgeon recently, and I said, give me a top-to-bottom number. And he's like, looks me up and down and says, 100 grand. I'm like, son of a bitch. You know? Anyway.
So you went to a budget gastric bypassist. Would you recommend visiting the same doctor to other women out there who are a little too hefty to get laid?
Go to Mexico. They do it about 5 grand.
Go to Mexico. Get a guy with a sombrero and a donkey to drink some tequila and take a butcher knife to your stomach.
Wow.
What about vaginal rejuvenation?
I've never done that, but I hear people are doing it all the time.
Down in Mexico.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
There's a clinic in TJ that will chop your pussy up and make that thing look nice.
Wow. From scratch, huh?
Give you Botox.
They're artists over there.
Give you Botox.
How would you say your love life changed from when you were when you were 255 to what? You're like 120 now? How did your love life change? And you're mostly boobs, babe. You got some... She's got some hammers, Danny.
Big tits?
Huge tits.
Mm.
Oh, huge.
Danny would be a big fan. Danny would be a big fan of those.
Oh. Yeah.
You can show him. You've got a picture. Anyway,
I get to look at a picture of your sugar mama's tits?
I think I have. I think I have shown him a picture of your boobs.
I don't remember that, Leandro.
I'll reshare.
I want Dino to see it, too. Is it all right, Mrs. Robinson, if our semi-retarded camera boy gets to see a picture of your breasts, too?
Perfectly fine.
Yeah,
he's 19. He's one of those skinny, tall kids with a big penis.
Yeah, he's great. You'd love him.
I know those ones. So before, when I was really heavy, you know, I know the fat side chick story because I've done it, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, and that's why I want to say that, I'll tell you this real quick. The ones that are pissed off in the comments, you know they're pissed off? They're all somebody's fat side chick. That's why.
That's why they're mad.
That aren't mad, it's because they're ugly.
Yeah.
They're not even somebody's.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay. They can't even get there.
So I want to answer to him and go, "Aw, honey, you're somebody's fat side chick, aren't you, sweetie? Well, bless you."
Mrs. Robinson, can you tell us a story about when you were that side chick? Maybe when you were down on your knees behind a Ralph's and then the guy zipped up his pants, said, "Thanks, sweetie," and drove off to the symphony with his real date?
Yeah, tell us one of those stories if you can, yeah.
You know, screwing my roommate's boyfriend. Yeah, I mean.
Oh my gosh. You're such a bad girl.
You know all the stories.
I do. I know a couple stories. I know a couple stories.
But I mean, yeah, I had twins in high school. I mean, yeah, I was a bad girl. I was the bad girl in high school.
Mrs. Robinson, can we talk about your relationship with Leandro?
Oh, God.
You can, but let me tell you this before.
Sure.
Yes, it did really me, but what it did was when I lost all the weight, and I'm not terribly unattractive for my age. I look okay, you know?
She looks great.
It allowed me to do things and do people that I never had the opportunity to do before. So I developed a real, how shall we say, a real taste for men in their 20s.
Yeah. Mm. Well, Leandro's out. Dino's in, almost.
I am 35 now, Miss Robinson, so
I'm available.
I know.
She hasn't been into me for a while now.
I'm available, Leo.
So, Gargoy, you just moved out of this shot.
Oh, okay. I'll move back into it.
It's either Vikings or, like, babysitter fantasy, so I think, like, only, like, Dino's got a shot in the hair right now.
I think Cigar Guy would work. Cigar Guy's a doughy guy who's unemployed and has been wearing the same T-shirt for 48 hours. Does that sound good to you?
Oh, my God.
He's also completely bald, Miss Robinson.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh,
not on his face, though.
Yeah, he's got a beard. He's got a beard, he's bald, and he wears a beanie every day.
Okay, the beard's really sexy. The beard thing is really sexy, yeah. I like the
beard.
I like that.
She likes the beard, yeah. She always tells me.
Yeah. But Leo, he's too old now, you know, so.
I'm too old for you.
Sugar mom.
Yeah, we're friends.
We're buddies.
Yeah. Hey, Mrs. Robinson, if you had to put a dollar figure on the funding that has flowed from your bank account into Leandro's, could you do that?
Son of a bitch.
I probably could, but I don't. It's not enough to hurt me, and it's just enough to keep him happy and make his life a little better.
Oh, thank you, baby.
Well, due to his tremendous paranoia of the IRS, I'm not sure what's enough to make him happy. Can you help me with that?
A few here and there. I mean, you know, I think
a few hundred thousand here and there.
No.
Yeah. A weekend getaway for him and his girlfriend. I've done some stuff like that. And, you know, rent some cars.
Something to brighten my day from time to time.
Oh, yeah. I remember us dressed like Napoleon going 100 miles per hour up the 5 in a top-of-the-line Mustang convertible once on her dollar.
Oh, yeah.
Was that just something to brighten the day?
She wanted to brighten our weekend.
With Napoleon costumes at a car that cost 45 grand.
Yeah, she wanted to brighten our day.
I do that for him all the time. I call him and say, "Here, I'm sending you money because I want you to have a great weekend or a great day."
She's like Mary Poppins in many ways.
I am.
I call her Mary Poppins. Sometimes.
Well, I mean, now that she's had gastric bypass, she couldn't have flown away in an umbrella before.
Yes.
No, the boobs hold me down.
She's got her boobs are just gigantic.
Oh, they're still so she still can't fly in an umbrella. Yeah, Mary Poppins does that, right?
Yes. Thank you. Mary Poppins, yes.
Sorry, we're talking about Mary Poppins, baby. Mrs. Robinson.
You've got a thing for Mary Poppins. Watch out.
Mrs. Robinson, at one point, Danny did offer, it was when he was single, when I first met him, he wanted me to walk him into a hotel room where you were going to be in a gimp suit.
Yeah.
And then have you, do whatever you wanted to him as part of payment for helping us with the channel. Because you really did help us out with this podcast. You were the original donor of the microphones. Mm-hmm. and kind of the starter gear. So we really appreciate it because now we've gotten so far. You know, we've come a long way.
We're on the Philip DeFranco show.
Yeah, exactly.
Because of things we said into the mics she bought.
Exactly, and they're the best top of the line mics, by the way. This is Joe Rogan and us. Well, right here, guys.
So it was crisp when I said those things about those people.
I was glad to help.
Thank you.
Anytime.
Thank you, Mr. Robinson. Mr. Robinson, what would your husband think of the arrangement you have going on with Leandro?
He would not be pleased with the arrangement.
Okay.
But to defend you in this, does your husband work?
No, he doesn't. I work. So he plays golf every day.
Every single day, lives off you. Pretty much. That correct, Ms. Robinson?
Mm-hmm.
So he sort of reminds me of these women who are getting mad at us for being quote-unquote fat-phobic. These women who think they are entitled to all the spoils of the world, penis-related and otherwise, despite the fact that they have no fucking discipline.
Pretty much all the jewelry that you see on me has been purchased by, except for, of course, the beautiful piece that Cigar Guy has gotten for me. Thank you. But yes, I would say you deserve a little bit of the side dick from time to time, Miss Robinson.
Yeah,
and maybe even more.
I do like the young ones.
Yeah, you deserve a cabana boy massaging your feet and, you know, motorboating your giant breasts every day.
Every day. That's why we are going to send on a Southwest flight our camera bitch, Dino. He's not going to be much for conversation, but in the sack, I think you'll find him sufficient.
Think of him as a very above-average-looking retarded boy.
Cut the name out. What'd you say?
Oh, shit. Did I say?
Yeah, you did.
Fucking me.
Did. Come on. This was your rule.
This was my rule. Please mark that. Yeah, please watch this entire sequence really well, Austin.
Is there a question?
But yeah, we'll send him your way, and it'll be great. I think you'll really enjoy him.
Mrs. Robinson, do you
have him a good time?
Mrs. Robinson,
yeah, you will.
I suggest you set up. Is she gone?
No, she's there.
Oh, I'm sorry. There was a hanging up noise. I suggest you set up an email address so that our fans can send you applications to be your new sugar babies. I don't think you're getting enough love on the side with just Leandro.
That's true. We could at least get you some good sexting going. There'll be hopefully some handsome young men who will send you pictures.
We got this guy, Seaman Hoffman.
Actually, we do. Oh, you would love Seaman Hoffman. There's this... he's a Navy officer that...
I like his name.
I don't think he's, I don't think he's an officer.
He's not an officer, but he is in the Navy, Ms. Robinson, and he was willing to do gay for pay for a little money. So you know he's down to do something for money. Something.
Oh, yeah.
He'll do anything.
Yeah, he's
fun. I found a skinny gay black guy that would be willing to do gay stuff with him for money. Like, if you paid Seaman Hoffman, he'll do the gay stuff with him for free.
The black guy will.
Yeah.
Everybody has a price. Please.
He said he'd do it for the
Everybody
porno.
Has a price.
And Seaman Hoffman's is $200. We should get him up on stage for the live show.
It's pretty low, the amount like that he'll be willing. He'll do a lot for very little money, too. So you'll love him.
Mrs. Robinson, the only last question I can think to ask you is, how many times have you sucked Leo's dick?
You son of a bitch.
Sweetheart, a lady never tells about that sort of thing, especially when the gentleman is in the room.
I forgot. They just tell about the Tijuana gastric gut bypass, but not the blowjob.
Well, he's sitting right there. That's not appropriate.
Yeah. She'll tell us sometime. We'll go visit her in whatever state she may be in.
Is the IRS in on your blowjob number too?
You son of a bitch. No, it's
clean. I travel a lot.
She travels a lot. Yeah, so we'll meet her somewhere random one day. And we will discuss this in person. Hey, babe.
Exactly.
Babe, you were amazing. Thank you for being you, Miss Robinson.
You're awesome, sweetheart.
My Mary Poppins.
Can we play her out with the Simon and Garfunkel song?
Yeah, let's play her.
No, it's just
one
nice
more time
to hear.
But tell the fat chicks to fuck off. They're just jealous and pissed
Thank
off.
You.
Well, you just told them for us, baby.
You told them for us.
That was nice.
Down.
That's right. Thank you, Miss Robinson.
You're so welcome, sweet.
You have a good day, okay?
All right,
I'll text you later.
You too, babe. All right.
All right, bye.
Bye-bye.
Oh, we got to let it play. There we go. And here's to all the fat girls want to cancel me and Leo. Oh,
fuck you.
Because I said I'd only fuck them in a hot tub at Equinox.
It'll
overflow. We had different ideas. You got the next verse. You got the chorus.
Oh, dude, no.
The chorus
cigar
is tough.
Guy, you go, bro. No, you can't,
hear the song. You can cut it off.
I can't.
Or fade it out. Fade it out, Austin. Come on, be a real radio producer here. Oh, that was nice. Well,
that was nice.
Hey, Leo and Danny Show clips guy, please isolate that clip so we have people can see we have a bona fide fat woman on our side.
100%.